taking out the term red flag. It was too broad a term. It's exactly what you're saying. I understand. Yeah. So with that change, that modification, I've made the motion to accept it.
Is there a second?
Second.
I had a roll call in. We have an open invoice that we've talked about the past, actually since October, to UMBA, that it pertains to, the invoice pertains to some charges. The invoice was sent to us, to the TIF. But it appears that there's items in there that pertain to the county's handling of the TIF funds over the past couple of years. I have a meeting tomorrow morning with Bridget Weber. She already has a copy of the invoice. I'm going to sit down and talk to her and get her feelings on it. If we can come to agreement on it, my thought was to ask UMBA to reissue an invoice to the county for their portion of it, and then we'll look at what's left on their base charge. But I want to talk to her tomorrow. Spend quite a bit of time with her on the phone in the past couple of days. Go over it. So, we're talking about it, I should say. I just want to bring everybody up to speed on that. Okay. We have some voices to be paid here. We'll go over the financials to begin with. Let's do the invoices first. We'll go over the financials. We have an invoice to Vieta, from Vieta for $50 to cover tonight's meeting. And then from Lowell from last week, earlier this month. There's an invoice in here to R.W. Armstrong, the amount of $32,081.70. Did everybody get a copy of that earlier this month?
Okay.
And that's their services, I believe, through March 26th. Hear a motion to approve those two invoices?
So moved.
The second.
Second.
Thank you. And roll call, please.
Ken Dorn.
Yes.
Doug Fry.
Yes.
John Schmalmer.
Yes.
Darrell Pullen.
Yes.
Paul Rutland.
Yes.
Okay. Now the financials, and I can address it better now that we've we've got $141,681 in our regular TIF account. There should be another payment to us sometime in June from the county. I don't know how much that will be yet. The redevelopment construction account right now has, after we pay these invoices, has $179,982 in it. That number is going to float because we're going to submit that Armstrong invoice for payment. we will get paid, reimbursed a portion of that back from NDOT. That's where we stand right now. Okay, any thoughts or questions from anybody in the committee?
Did we talk about or determine how to proactively reallocate some of those monies?
I did talk to June about it, John. Her feeling was that she would, until we get the money in June, she would rather stay with her cap right now. And I know we're paying interest on that. I believe our interest, we've paid back, remember here, I believe, $200,000 back on the original $1 million we borrowed.
We owe $900,000. $150,000.
And we paid $16,000 interest payment. So you're showing the balance, correct?
$900,000. 3.5%.
Her feeling was that until we get that money in June, she would rather sit with that money there. I express our feelings about that. I guess I'm going to bow to her experience.
We get the, we've got not returned the cap.
No, part of our problem there, John, has always been that we don't know what that portion is. I can't determine, and I've asked the question, I can't determine whether that $1 million that we borrowed should be viewed as a bridge loan as we were building a house or not. In other words, you borrow what you need from it, pay back what you don't need from it, etc. I can't get that determination of that structure, and I don't think that would be.
I've talked with Rick about that. I mean, again, I don't think they envision it to be kind of a bridge loan either, but I think we have paid
$800,000.
Yeah, and I don't think there isn't any resistance from, is it IBT? No, it's
First Federal and
IBT.
IBT is
the Indiana Bank and Trust.
Yeah, so. I think it was cracked, and I don't think that was the intention necessarily, but I don't know that all the financial institutions necessarily fall into that pain in that net.
So we should try to
think. Well, I think what June said is she would like a little more time before that's done, but
get in the range of $300,000.
Junior? I guess from my standpoint, and I'm telling you, this is just me speaking, if we held at the levels we have here, I think that anything that we get in payment to the county in June, we should be able to put toward paying that down. Possibly even looking at some of this, I don't know how the rest of it.